Time for another edition of Tim's Vinyl Confessions. I'm Tim Durling. I want to thank you for tuning into this episode, as you always do. Really appreciate all the follows, all the likes, all the shares, the comments. And today I'm going to go through my CD collection of a guy who, pretty big name in Canada, sadly kind of a cult hero in the States and the rest of the world. Although those that know his music, they know what a great singer-songwriter he is. And what a fantastic guitar player he is. I'm talking about Kim Mitchell. In Canada, you know, you say Kim Mitchell, yeah, I know who he is. Sadly, in other parts of the world, he's an undiscovered treasure. I'm not going to go through Kim's stuff with Max Webster, because that's a band I'm still just getting into, and I haven't got nearly everything yet, but I'm really, really enjoying sort of having a renaissance getting into Max Webster stuff. Max Webster was Kim Mitchell's band from 75 to 1980, 81. And if you're a fan of Rush, then you'll have seen the name Max Webster many, many times. So when I get my Max Webster collection up to a standard that I can go through most of the stuff, or at least, or if not all of it, until then, I'm not going to do that. And actually, even in Canada, Max Webster were more of a cult band. Kim Mitchell on his own became a bigger deal, a pretty big solo star. So, and not all the CDs are that easy to find nowadays. One in particular, really, really hard to find. So I'll go through them on Tim's Vinyl Confessions. I did an episode a while ago where I went through top 10 EPs in my collection, according to me. And I mentioned one of them that you're about to see, that a CD I paid $80 for because it went out of print it was only in print for a very short period of time. And it went out of print soon after that. So that was the copy I ended up getting. After Max Webster, Kim Mitchell put his first solo EP out in 1982 on Anthem Records. I think it only ever came out in Canada. And it never saw anything past vinyl or cassette release for whatever reason. And in 2004, a company called Wounded Bird put it out for a very short window of time. And that's the CD that I paid all the money for. So Kim Mitchell's five-song self-titled debut EP from 1982. This is the incredibly rare CD version, one of the rarest CDs that I own. This is a great EP. Has a lot more to do with the Max Webster sound than what he would later do. If you've got the best of Max Webster, you've got the song Kids in Action, which for a while was the only thing I had off the CD. Anything I had that was on this album on a CD form. That's what the CD itself looked like, and there's not much in it for credits. The same as what was on the back cover of the album, and inside of it, just kind of a reprint of that. So I'm glad I was able to track that down, because it's probably even more expensive now. It's one of those things where I couldn't foresee a big reissue campaign happening for whatever reason. So the first full-length Kim Mitchell album was a success, pretty much right out of the gates in Canada, a Kimbo logo. It's had a couple different cover art. This is what my CD looks like. There's also a blue album cover of this, different pose. Kimbo logo. This contained Gopher Soda, Lagered Ale, That's a Man, All We Are, all big, big videos on Much Music, particularly Gopher Soda, which was his only song that made any kind of an impact in the States. I think it charted somewhere in the 80s on the top 100, and I think got all the way to number 12 on the Billboard Rock chart. So other than that, he's pretty much a cult hero in the States. But this is a good, good album. Good hard rock album. Melodic, too. This is on Alert Records. A lot of Canadian independent labels started with A for some reason. It was Anthem, Aquarius, Alert, Attic. So Max Webster and Kim Mitchell's solo EP were on Anthem. But Tom Barry, who worked for Anthem, started his own label. And that was Alert Records. So Kim went there with some other Canadian acts. This is what was inside the CD. This version I got came from Columbia House as one of his biggest albums. I don't think it was his biggest, though. I think Kim's most successful album was this one, Shaken Like a Human Being. This came out in 1986. Patio Lanterns was a song that was big off of this, much popular tune for him. That made the American, the Billboard Rock charts, too. Not as high as Gopher Soda. Easy to Tame was another hit single off of this one. And there's some great hard rock songs on here too, like Get Lucky, That's the Hold. Good stuff. This is, again, Alert Records, so it's obviously Canadian. This album came out in the States on Atlantic Records. but I don't think it came out on CD. I think it only came out on record and cassette. So what I find is interesting about this is that they just reprinted the back cover of the record because it says also available on compact disc and cassette. This is the compact disc. Anyway, this is Kim Mitchell, lyrics. This guy here is Pai Dubois, who was Kim's lyricist at this point and was Max Webster's lyricist, which is why a lot of his lyrics, they're quirky and they don't sound like your typical rock lyrics, which is kind of one of the things that made Max Webster unique. And even though Kim Mitchell's solo stuff was a little bit more, dare I say, conventional, it still had that little quirkiness to it, which maybe is one of the reasons why he never quite cracked the U.S. market. Who knows? The next Kim Mitchell album came out in 1989. This one also came out on Atlantic Records. I have seen Atlantic Records versions of this on CD, but I already had it. So this is Rockland. This is a Canadian version, On Alert, from Columbia House. Rock and Roll Duty was a hit off of this one. And to a lesser extent, Rockland Wonderland, the quasi-title song. This one's just got lyrics and credits in it. So, in 1990, Alert put out a live album from Kim Mitchell called I Am a Wild Party. The song of the same name was a studio recording. I don't know why it was such a brief album. It's only 8 songs on here, and 2 of which were brand new songs, 1 of which is a studio recording. So that left 6 or 7 live songs. They could have put more on here. The cool thing about it is that one of them, track 3 on here, is Battle Scar, the Max Webster song that they actually did with Rush. Now, I got into this before I knew much about Max Webster. I knew of a song called Battle Scar, but I didn't put 2 and 2 together. And I got to credit my buddy Chad for saying, have you heard Max Webster's Battle Scar? And played it for me. I'm like, this is a Rush song. Pretty much. Anyway, in case you're wondering, Kim's longtime bassist, Peter Fredette, is the one that sings the high part, so he would have tackled the Geddy Lee section of that song. So a few crowd shots here, and thanks to all of the cities he's played in, mostly Canadian cities. Then it was kind of a gap before he put anything else out, and he put out a great album in 1992 called Oral Fixations. I'll give you a second to figure that out. It's A-U-R-A-L. So, has to do with sound, of course. And I don't think this album came out in the States at all, aside from imports. Again, this is Alert Records and Columbia House. Some great songs on here. Different co-writes on here. He co-writes a couple songs with Andy Curran, who was in Coney Hatch. So again, this is like an Anthem Records connection there. Not much in here. There's no lyrics in here. It's just kind of a chart of the songs. Kind of a studio, different states of readiness the songs were in, and a little bit of credits and the song titles. The next thing to come out from Kim Mitchell after that was in 1994, and he just called the album Itch, with this sort of strange pink album cover, so the Itch is out of his name. This is a different album. There are some interesting songs on here. It's not one that I play all that much, but always interesting. It's kind of hard to read the side of that. This is, like many of mine, it's on Alert Music, and it is Columbia House issued. It's very mid-90s looking as far as packaging goes. These are the lyrics. They're kind of hard to see here, but you can read them when you actually open it up. But so in 1995, inevitably, an artist has had any amount of success, puts out a best of or greatest hits, and this is Kim Mitchell's greatest hits. 1995 from Alert Music, also Columbia House. And his name here is made up of various images from some of his album covers and or videos, which is kind of neat. It's a pretty good collection, and it's good for the casual fan, except for the fact that, for some reason, Patio Lanterns and Logger Nail, or new recordings. I don't know why they didn't put the original versions on here. There were 2 new songs on here, both of which were quite good. So, pretty good overview of his career. cover of the CD booklet, and a little bit of credits and a short write-up from the band himself. This is what the actual disc came out looked like when it came out. And on the back cover, behind the disc, are the lyrics to the two new songs, No More Walking Away and Rainbow. It was the last thing he put out for a while, till 1999. I think Alert Records kind of went under or was absorbed into another company. So, 1999, this album came out called Kemosabe. And the version I have is on Chinook and Oasis Company. So this is a Canadian version, which is probably all there was. Not something you see that much anymore. Disc itself. And a little bit of credits and some pictures. And one more thing to show you. To this day, the last thing that Kim Mitchell put out was a pretty good album. Put it in 2007 called Ain't Life Amazing. Pretty much did this himself on his own label. There's no real label listed on here. I did buy it at HMV, so it's a Canadian purchase. Like I said, some good stuff on here. Typical lyrics and credits. And Kim Mitchell tours constantly throughout Canada. I go see him again. I've seen him once in concert. And again, I'm also really, really looking into the Max Webster stuff and exploring that back catalog, because it's some of that stuff is way out there, and a lot of it is just really, really good. So I'd recommend checking out Kim Mitchell stuff if you like. It's hard to compare him to any one artist, but I would start hitting up YouTube. You know, Go for Soda's his most popular, probably his most popular rock tune. If you like that, then I would dig a little further down the side. I'm sure you could see some other recommendations. So thanks for watching this edition of Tim's Vinyl Confessions.